Hey, what's up everyone? It's Derek from Nerd or Die, and I'm gonna show you how to set up our latest overlay package, Uplink. In this video, I'll show you how to quickly and easily get this pack set up inside of Streamlabs OBS, and I'll walk you through how to customize the colors and text and media sources used as well. We'll also go over how to install, use, and customize the goal widgets included with this pack. Let's get right into it. So if you don't have Streamlabs OBS, you can use our affiliate link in the description below to download it directly. We've worked hand in hand with Streamlabs in order to make our products easy to install and customize, so we definitely recommend checking it out. However, if you prefer to use OBS Studio instead, then I recommend checking out some of our other videos about adding sources into OBS Studio, which you can find in the description below. The pack comes with all the media files you'll need to use with either software, so even if you're with OBS Studio, this tutorial will still cover the basics that you'll need to know and that you can even follow along since they're very similar. Also, don't forget to subscribe with notifications on, as we have some new awesome free resources coming out soon. With the pack downloaded and unzipped, open up Streamlabs OBS and click the Settings tab on the top right. From there, click Scene Collections and then Import Overlay File. Next, the .overlay file found in the Streamlabs folder of your overlay pack can be clicked to open it up here. After a few seconds, this will import all of the overlay files and sources and scenes, and it will be basically ready to use from there. Before I forget, make sure that you check out the readme file included with this package, as it will contain more details on the setup process included in this video. The first scene you'll see includes instructions about how to use the product correctly. I recommend reading through this guide quickly and then deleting the scene once you're ready to rock. Now, not only will your scenes be set up for you, but the stinger transition should be set up as well. When you change scenes, you should see the stinger transition fire off, so let's move on to the stream starting scene. If you need to edit the stinger though, you can do so by clicking the gear icon above the scenes area. Here, you'll find the transition and connection tabs. For transitions, you'll see that we've made a global transition with the type of stinger. You can click the edit button and see the properties we've used for this transition. You can also use the dropdown for type if you'd like to change the type of transition used. For instance, you can use a cut or fade type by changing it here. When you're done with changing up the stinger options, click Done and let's move on to swapping out some of the text and images. On the stream starting scene, we see some social icons and calendar information that we can actually change very easily. One of the nice features here is folders, which can help us organize these sources a bit better. If we expand the social folder, you'll find the sources we use to make all of these sections possible. Let's scroll down a bit and double-click the source title Twitter URL. This will open up the text source properties. At the top, you'll see we're using a Google font. If you happen to want to use a font installed on your local machine, you can uncheck this and use any font that you'd like. You can, of course, change any of the base options here, but let's edit the text inside of the text box. You simply need to update this to your Twitter handle and hit Done. Then repeat this process for any other text sources throughout the entire overlay package. Don't forget that you can click on these sources directly in the preview area, but you will need to double-click any sources that are in a folder in order to highlight this source directly. Next, let's say that we don't use Discord and want to swap out this icon. We need to find the source that we put this icon in, so I'll just double-click on the icon directly in the preview area and find the highlighted source in the source panel. Double-click on the source to open up its properties. We're going to click Browse and navigate to our overlay files. From here, select the Icons folder and the Large subfolder, and pick out any icon that you'd like to replace it with. Again, just repeat this for any source you'd like to swap out. If you like, you can also right-click the sources and choose Rename to make the source name referencing something that the source represents. This process should be pretty quick and easy, and you will need to repeat it for any other scenes that you'll be using. One of our favorite parts about this design is how easy it is to pick and choose colors. Now, to do this, let's take a look at the in-game layout horizontal scene. Here, you'll see a bunch of different elements that you can reposition, hide, or remove completely. We wanted to give you the ability to get creative and be able to adapt to almost any game UI. By the way, if your event list or goal widgets don't look like the ones here or don't look like the ones that Uplink is supposed to come with, this is because you're using your currently activated widget themes inside of Streamlabs. We'll cover how to swap out the default widget theme and install the goal widgets a bit later, so don't worry on that just yet. To change the color of the sources, let's select the webcam frame on the left for this example. When we scroll through the sources, we'll be able to find that we've selected a source called Webcam 16:9 Standard. Right-click the source and choose Filters. You'll actually see that we've already added a color correction filter to each source, but if you don't, you can just hit the plus icon and select the type of filter that you need, which will be a color correction filter. Then you can even remove these with the minus button. Anyways, the easiest way to change the colors is by adjusting the hue shift slider until you find a hue that you like. Once you're close to the color that you like, you can also adjust the saturation, brightness, and contrast if needed. But what if you need a more exact color and you don't want to guess and estimate that color? We'll cover that in just a second. First, let's go ahead and pretend that we're happy with the color that we've landed on and want to apply that color to other sources. After we click Done, we can right-click the source with the new color applied and choose Copy Filters. From here, we want to select the source that we want to apply the new color to, right-click it, and hit Paste Filters. Repeat this process for any other sources that you want to add this color to. One final thing about colors that we wanted to give users was a way to quickly choose an exact color via a hex code, in case they want to stay on brand, or even just make selecting a color palette easier. To do this, we've included a white theme of each overlay file. Using white as a base rather than the orange that we started with will allow you to choose the exact colors needed. The first step we need to do is swap out the media files you'd like to use. So in our stack scene, I'll choose the webcam frame on the left, which is the 16:9 standard frame. Double-click the source to open up its properties and navigate to the white theme found in the overlay files. Then we'll go into the webcam 16:9 folder and choose the standard version. You'll see it swap out to white, and from here we can just add a color filter to take care of that. So let's go ahead and right-click on the source, go back into filters, and in our color source filter we need to scroll down and use the color picker section here. Below the color we'll see the ability to enter in a hex code or even RGB values. For this example, I'll enter in FF0000, which is red, and you'll see it swap to exactly the hex code FF0000. This involves a little bit more of work, but it gives you precise controls of the colors that you're using. We've even pieced out the overlay a little bit more inside of this theme to give you exactly what you need to truly customize your overlay and colors. Now it's time to cover setting up the goal widget. If you use our alerts in the past, then this process will be very similar. If not, don't worry, we'll walk you through all the steps that you need. First, navigate to the main folder for this project and choose the goal widgets folder. After that, double-click on the type of goal widget you'd like to install. If you'd like, choose Create Profile and name it something appropriate such as Uplink. The import link will only override the widgets that you're choosing to install. So for example, if you're importing the design for a donation goal, this will not affect your alerts or other goal widgets. Select Use for the profile that you want to import into. If you already have a theme for the Uplink alerts or other goals, then you can import that into here. Now, normally in OBS Studio, you'd need to copy the widget URL and paste it in as a browser source, but in Streamlabs OBS, we can do this a bit differently. You'll see that we've already added a donation goal widget in the pre-setup example, but if you'd like to change this or add more, you can click the plus by the source panel and choose the type of widget that you'd like to add. Then go ahead and hit Add Source, Add New Source. Once you've done that, you can set some properties. And for this example, we recommend making the width at least 430 and the height around 500 pixels. You can reposition and resize the source as needed. Anyways, as I mentioned before, we added in a donation goal, so you can use that or delete it and add the type of goal widget that you'd like to use instead. If your goal is not showing up properly from here, then make sure that you have one started inside of the Streamlabs options. This can be done within the dashboard tab of the Streamlabs OBS software or on the Streamlabs website. If you started a new goal and it's still not showing, you'll need to go into the goal's properties, scroll down, and choose Refresh Cache in order to refresh the goal. If your goal is set up and working, then it's time to take a look at how we can customize it. Let's do this for the donation goal. Go to the Dashboard tab or use the Streamlabs website and choose Goals, Donation Goals. From here, click the Settings tab, scroll down a bit, and find the Custom Fields tab. You'll see all sorts of options, and we highly recommend checking out the readme file included in the main folder, and under the Goal Widget tab, you'll find more details on each setting. The first is to flip the goal widget, and this is very useful if you want to align the widget to the other side of your webcam frame or overlay setup. Next, you'll have a font to choose from. The default that we use is Dosis. And after that, you have a slew of colors to edit that you can just quickly use the color pickers. And we've even included colors from the marker that is showing where your goal is to the color that flashes when your goal is reached. After all of the colors, you'll have the font weight or thickness of the font. But I do want to say that not all fonts have multiple weights, so just be mindful of that. And the highlight area is the area that is shown behind your goal's current amount, and the opacity slider lets you change it from solid to see-through. Finally, you have a prefix which can change from the dollar sign to euro sign, for example, a suffix that shows after the goals, so this can typically be the word bits or something like that. And then once you're done with all of your settings, go and refresh your goals cache to see changes in the editor. If you want to test your goals quickly, you can go into your dashboard and resend any alerts that you've had. But if you don't have any alerts for donations or something like that, then we can go to the My Donations tab and add a new donation just to test things out and make sure that everything's working. And you can enter in custom amounts and see what happens once you don't get to the goal or once you get over the goal, and just make sure everything looks great there. One quick thing that I did want to point out that sometimes confuses our users is why their widgets switch when changing scenes or scene collections. If you go to the Widgets Theme tab in the Streamlabs dashboard, you'll see all of your widget themes. But you'll also see your scene collections on the right, which should now include the Uplink preset scene collection since we installed it through Streamlabs OBS. The dropdown here is the widget theme to use when using the scene collection. Make sure that this is set to the widget theme that you created for the Uplink pack. Now, if you're not sure what scene collections are, they're basically a collection of all of your overlay sources and scenes. Inside of Streamlabs OBS, you can click the dropdown located above this scene section and then go ahead and switch between scene collections quickly and easily. This makes it very easy if you have a lot of different games that you play or you just want to change your style up every once in a while. A final tip is regarding performance. We get emails all the time asking why their CPU usage is high. The most common reason is that users don't remove unused media files. Each media file, especially the animated movie files, can use CPU. We highly recommend removing these files or at least making sure they're set to close file when inactive in the source properties, especially if you're not using them. Basically, any animation will add up, so just be mindful of that. With all of that, you should now know everything that you need to know about the Uplink Stream Pack. We put a lot of effort into this one, and I really, really hope that you guys all enjoy it. If you have any questions at all, please leave them in the comments below. We do our best to get to all of them, but if we don't, you can always use our support tab if you purchase the pack and get us questions there that we can reply to quickly. Also, don't forget to subscribe with notifications on so that you don't miss out on our next free resource or stream packs. Thanks for watching.